Welcome to Songbringer, day 230 something. Today I'm going to be experimenting with some diagonal movement in the game. I've always had it purposely not have diagonal movement. It's meant to be a 8-bit feeling. However, I've gotten several feedback comments lately from the alpha version. People saying, they'd prefer to have diagonal movement, so let's try it out. I tried this out a long time ago when I was first creating a game, first was starting everything, and so I guess it's worth a try to try it again. What's up, Arcane? Pedro? Yo, you guys? So, that's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna try out diagonal movement. Yep, but definitely needed a break there after that alpha version. I feel like I still need more of a break, but gotta stream. What up, PETA? Welcome. So creating a hero. If I want to try out diagonal movement, first I guess I gotta bind the controls for this other controller, so I can try it out with some actual the controller rather than just the keyboard. So I got my Xbox controller. Bind these keys really quick. I played some awesome games last night. I played Nidhogg finally. Yeah, it went great, man. Incredible. Yeah, the alpha turned out really, really great. I mean, already several people have done playthroughs. The store page is up. Really proud of the store page. Check that out. There's the Jib's backstory on there, so it kind of explains, how Jib got to be who he is and stuff. And what else? Pocket Gamer wrote about the game. Pocket Gamer. There it is. Yep, so this is pretty cool too. So rad. I mean, they just reached out to me. Nice, PETA. Thanks, man. Yeah, you guys are having crazy internet, huh? It's down. It's not down here. So, got some keys bound. Let's make sure that turned out right. Got those bindings and those bindings. Here's the bindings for that. Cool. So we've got that. Let's make sure that works in the game. Just run around. Yeah, cool. Right. Hello, bit of Barney. So the next thing in the profile for Rock, the main character. I think this is where we can set what input is allowed. Forget where this is actually. It would be part of his movement. I'm not sure if that's actually there. Yeah, the GUI's different. El Capitan has this whole like bar thing up here. And it's black. You can make it black, which is really cool. You can invert all of your whole OS's colors or whatever. But apparently that didn't work for Xcode. Nice. Right on. So it looks like it's not allowing movement diagonally by default. Somewhere in here where it's creating the hero, it creates a being. Here it is. Which then creates, sometimes creates an AI, but this would not be a, this is just a being. So where does it create the input component? Here it is. It adds an input component. But then later it creates the entity. Here's where it creates the entity. Input flags. Here it is, input flags. Ah, it's just the allow input flag. Ah, here we go. All right, that's all we need for this. So in Rock's profile, we'll do an allow input and give him every single direction. See how this feels. So once again, I've tried this before when I first started the game. I tried diagonal movement and I really did not like it. In fact, it just didn't work. It did not seem to work for me. But so like so many people have commented on the alpha version saying they wish they had diagonal movement, so. I guess it's better than it used to be. Yeah, I guess it is better. Design choice, man. So back in the day when I first made this choice, why was it so much different then? Well, first of all, the Y factor was different. So this whole diagonal movement wasn't as, didn't look right because it was moving north-south just as fast as it was moving east-west. And this is a really long, let's just save and quit. Okay, I want to try that again with the keyboard. Zeith, hey, what's up, man? Would I have to rework any of the A star to use diagonals? No, there is no A star yet as far as the way enemies move. A star is just used for the overworld right now in determining the right paths for for placing levels. So there is no pathfinding going on for enemies yet. But yes, I would have to rework it. If I were to go create pathfinding, I would have to use a smarter A star. You know, just it wouldn't be that much more difficult. All you gotta do is say, okay, this diagonal movement is possible. No, enemies cannot attack diagonally. That's a really, really good point. Yeah. They can't yet. But if I allow this, if I turn on diagonal movement, eventually the enemies, I'll get them to work diagonal too. Yeah. Oh, the yeah, see melee? That's what I'm gonna try next. Projectiles. I guess enemies would already had that ability. They just didn't use it. So, for example, the bats, for example, they move diagonally, and you could easily have a projectile moving diagonally, too. Yeah, thanks, man. Thank you. That really helps, because right now, I'm still kind of in a brain-dead state, just like this. I feel like I haven't recovered from kind of being burnt out from having to do this from so many bugs from the alpha version. But, yeah, so thank you. Thank you, because... my brain can hardly take it right now. But yeah, okay, let's try out keyboard movement. See if that, how that feels with diagonal in there. Let's put the player back at the beginning. That's a kind of a bad area. The bad part of town. Let's get rid of this second. Yeah, so here we go. Seven. So actually, with the Xbox controller, it felt pretty good. I mean, with the keyboard, it's a little bit different because I'm using Vim keys, right? I'm using H, J, K, and L. I can bind those to something else, though. In fact, let's add some more bindings. So make diagonal movement a little easier. So I'm going to bind the actual arrow keys. Hopefully that'll probably make more sense to my fingers to use diagonal movement with the actual arrow keys. Yeah, you know what? I don't know what my problem was before. Maybe it was the enemies. I feel like it was something to do with the enemies. Let's just try and give the blobs some diagonal movement right now. See what they're like, if they can move diagonally. Maybe some blobs, and this might be cool because then some blobs would be able to move only four compass directions and some would be able to move diagonal or eight compass directions. So, same thing as in Rock's profile. Let's give the regular blobs this diagonal movement. And same thing with the blob two. That's the bigger blob in that one little mob there. I definitely like it better with the Xbox controller, which is, you know, of course you're gonna, with the controller, which has like an analog stick style, you know. Oh wow, look at that. So sometimes they're randomly choosing directions sometimes, and sometimes they randomly choose a diagonal. Look at that, they're totally stuck though. I mean, that's just making the AI smarter though. I can work on that. Yeah, this guy only wants to move northwest at this point. He's totally stuck. He doesn't even care that I'm over here. You don't even care, dude. What's up? Okay, I think I can live with diagonal movement in here. It's definitely not as easy with the keyboard, but I mean, it's possible with the keyboard, so. Definitely a lot easier with the arrow keys though. Okay. This ain't so bad. Bit of Barney, yeah, that screen transition is off. There's a problem with the grass. I'm not sure what happened, but yeah. Professional Novice, what's up, man? Hey. Thanks, Zeth, yeah. It definitely has. There's a lot of other sections, too. There's a dark forest, there's mountains, and they all kind of look different, like different biomes. So yeah, in regards to this transition here, the biggest problem is that you see that this little indentation right here on this screen, and then you don't see the indentation here, so it doesn't look like a clean transition. I think what frame rate am I running at? I'm at 60 right now. I'll turn that down to 30 while I'm streaming. Because my computer is starting to do its fan thing. Yeah, thanks, man. Nice, right on. What I'm working on today, I'm trying out diagonal movement. So I just added that back in. This is something I've had for the entire game. Every entity has always had the ability to move diagonally. But I disabled it quite a long time ago because it didn't feel right. But now, I think there's the most important part that actually makes it feel right now is there's this movement factor on the y-axis, which basically, if the player is moving around, the player moves faster east-west than he does north-south because there's more depth. So there's, you know, if even though this is a widescreen aspect ratio, right? So the height of the screen is shorter than the width of the screen. But so that's exactly why the player needs to move a little bit slower going north-south than they do going east-west. And you can barely even tell. You know, it looks about the same, but it feels better. So I think that's what's making this whole diagonal movement feel better than it used to. It's really awkward with the Vim keys, though. But that's just because I chose those keys for binding. So, yeah. Definitely a lot better with the Xbox controller. The Xbox controller is really smooth and... yeah. So the one thing that kind of... I don't know, I'm kind of like, about this is because I really wanted this to be an 8-bit feeling game, but I don't know. I guess this is more fun, right? It's more fun to be able to move diagonally. Okay. Let's okay. So the next thing I'm gonna try is I'm gonna dial in the diagonal attacks. So let's make melee so melee can actually be diagonal too. What up, Boogie? You're liking nice. I'm liking it too, I have to admit. I thought I was gonna be more stubborn about this, but I'm not. What up, Blood? How you doing, man? How's Pierre? All right, so I'm going to turn on debug and take a look at the actual hitboxes for the player, especially when he's swinging the sword. Where is his hitbox? I don't think it's going to change the hitbox at all. Oh, I'm going to turn off all the flies and hoppers and stuff because they're just overwhelming. So turning on only foes, which will turn off all those other little entities and make it easier to work with here. There we go. So we just got the player. So as you can see, when I'm facing left, there's a big rectangle. That's what makes the game. That's what makes the sword feel so so comprehensive, I guess, and where it strikes. It's a big range. It's a big sword. So now I just get the diagonal movement. So if you're attacking diagonally, it does. Oh, see there. Wait, what was that? Oh, south movement. It's like, it's kind of already doing diagonal move. What was that? That was really weird. So, if I'm on the regular compass directions, the hitboxes are normal. But there's this one direction where I saw I was moving one direction and the hitbox was a totally different direction. There, that happened again. Looks like we need some special hitbox considerations for if we're on a diagonal. All right. Yep. So you mentioned it, and two of the people that did Let's Plays mentioned it, and I think somebody else mentioned it too. It's like all of a sudden everybody mentioned diagonal movement, and I had made the choice a long time ago to not have diagonal movement, but now that things are a little bit different with the game, it actually feels okay. So I think I'm gonna put this in. The only reason I was kind of wanting to be stubborn was because I really wanted this to feel like an 8-bit game, but guess you kind of got to make these choices. If the game's more fun with diagonal movement or without, you know, not just trying to be stubborn about the 8-bit thing. So, yeah, I just got to be more flexible, more open. So let's look at the actually where it puts it, the hitboxes with the attack system. What's this? I have this function called getAttackDir for an entity. Yeah. Oh, that might be an option. Just a an option for that. I don't know. I don't really want to make this an option, a settings option, because if the games are either going to be this way or it's not, you know. If it has diagonal movement, that's kind of a permanent choice, I think. Yeah, rest in peace, that thing. I know, so many lines of code, right? Especially in this file. Oh yeah. Maybe I should spend a week and just code, make the code cleaner. I don't know. What are we up to now? 37, almost 38,000 lines of code. Yes, that's. That should be part of this. Start melee. Yeah. What up, Marza? Don't waste my time. Right? Yeah. Well, it kind of is in the sense that every line of code is a maintenance, you know what I mean? This could be time down the road. If I have a really nice organized design, well-designed system with well-organized files, it's going to be easier in the long term to maintain this code. You say release then refactor? I don't know about that. Right? Yeah, what am I thinking? What am I thinking? Not a high priority right now, I guess. Pay somebody to rewrite the whole thing? If the game does make money. I don't know, we'll see. Start melee. Okay, this method here. It's so fundamental. Should be right here next to this one so I can see them both at the same time. Last compressor, compressor. Okay, these are different methods. It will. That'd be great. Would be awesome. I try not to have any expectations, you know? So if the game does make money, then awesome. If it doesn't, it doesn't really matter. I made this whole game because it was what I wanted to create. And even if no one ever played it, which people already have, which is freaking awesome, you know what I mean? When you start a game, you don't know if anybody else is ever going to enjoy it. You don't know if you're ever going to make money. But now people are enjoying it. I know some people on this very stream right now that have enjoyed it. So that's pretty cool. That's true. Totally true. I've been reminded of this from releasing the alpha version because I realized that people that play it don't really care how it works. You know, it doesn't matter how the code is. Yeah. Yeah, exactly. Nice. I like this analogy. Oh, see, this is where it's I already had some diagonal stuff here. All right, this is only if you have zero attack boxes, so the main player is never gonna run this code. But this is the part that's pretty important, right? So he's doing southwest or northwest. It always does direction west. Northeast or southeast, it always does direction east. So that's gonna be, you know, what happens if I just comment that out? Let's try that. It's gonna need some custom logic. So all the diagonal directions are gonna need the hitbox to be moved up and, you know, on the north-south axis and the east-west axis, not just one. That's okay. These south ones are weird. It uses the same hitbox. So that one's right, the pure south. That one uses the, yeah. So here's where it actually does, wait, no, this isn't it, not there, it's, yeah, this should be its own method. Yeah, I do believe that should be. Yeah, Marza's professional. I think there's a bunch of people here. They're professional programmers. For sure. There's lots of us. Here I am. I am here. Oh, by the way, I did do, I started that Frankfurt's thing, or Frankerface thing, so the jib will be an actual, jib will be a thing we can do. Oh, it's a lowercase s. So, one method at a time, get it a little cleaned up. There we go, a little more organized. But the real point of all this is to make it do this diagonal movement. So right here, this is why. It's only got left, right, up, and down as far as where it places the position and size of the hitbox. Let's just make sure this works though. The build still works as it used to. Cool. And this is why it's combining things together. Okay. This is up, down. With the old system, there were only four compass directions. That's why all this worked. But now with this new system, just put in some else's, I guess. See how that feels. But yeah, we do need some custom logic for those diagonals. It's kind of like a combination of left and right, but. So yeah, that's a little bit more to be expected. Now, I'm going in a diagonal direction, it's only using the north or south with that else in there. We take the else's out. Why? Let's say I'm moving southeast. That would be positive or negative y, positive x. What was the problem direction? So really, take a quick break. We'll be right back. Mulberry, what's up, man? So, considering the southwest and southeast directions, that would trigger the down here, which would move its position down by a bit. However, I don't want to quite do. This is the attack box. I want to do the whole thing. So if we have horizontal movement, I think I want that to be half as far down, otherwise, all the way down. Let's see what that looks like. So yeah, anyway, just showing the stream. I'm working on diagonal movement today. Do we have? Yes, we do. We had one time where my entire screen was full of BC Warriors. It was like a 17. It's crazy. That's what I wanted. Okay. Oh, okay, I see what's going wrong with the when I'm going north and south, it really widens up that hitbox. Yeah, so now southeast and southwest are looking pretty good. But northeast and northwest are not. They're a little too big. Oh yeah, well, it probably was. Probably was. I guess that would be, yeah. Kofez, hello man. What do you mean by perspective camera? You show me a visual example? Like send me a link or a picture or something to check out so the upward. So yeah, okay, so north size y plus equal gotcha. Right, perspective view, but that's what perspective are you talking about? This isn't really helping, man. Can you show me, tell, I'm talking about, send me an example of a game that is using a perspective view. Maybe that, sorry, man, my brain is not already 100%, not 100% today, so. That's right, don't forget. Let's do a similar thing to that. Ah, okay, yeah, that works. It's normally about that big, and then it gets to be that big. Okay. I'm gonna do a little, hey, what up, Wissiso? Welcome, man. Render distance in the z-axis. Rayman. I mean, I've seen Rayman, I just forget what exactly what perspective he uses. Rayman Legends? You mean a regular side scroller? Dude, this is easy to do pixel art with these. What? I'm still having trouble trying to answer your question. You're asking why is perspective camera bad for pixel art games? If this is what you mean by perspective camera, then this is easy for pixel art games. This is the easiest camera angle of all camera angles to do art for. This one is so easy. The side scroller, platformer, that is the easiest art style there is. You're not looking at the very top or edges or anything. You're looking straight on at almost everything, and it makes it very, very easy to develop games, to draw games for, and to do the game engine for them. Okay, so what do you mean then? What do you mean by a perspective camera? Can you show me a screenshot of a game that you're talking about? What, maybe clarify what you're asking? Okay, I'm gonna do always screen cap and record the player moving in every direction so I can measure all these boxes and make sure these are actually correct. How can you pixel art a 3D game? You use flat entities. A lot of games do this, and that's great because you can actually do rad shadows that way and stuff. Yeah, just use billboards, exactly. Or just pixel art the textures, yeah. Having a vanishing point in the Z direction. So there's a lot of depth to the camera. I guess that makes sense. How would you do that with pixel art? You just wouldn't put as, you know, you would use, just make sure everything is still rendered in pixels. Have some depth, but make sure the things in the distance are really small pixels. Yeah, I mean, this is still just, it's totally possible with pixel art. So, if this were a pixel art game, all you'd have to do is just make sure your stuff that's way in the background is still at the same pixel depth that you're rendering your whole game at. I mean, it does make it hard if you're going to zoom in and out and stuff, but as long as you're drawing everything to a frame buffer first, and you, so it really doesn't matter. Like, yeah, in fact, that solves everything. Kofez, all you need is a frame buffer. Yeah, well, maybe it's some, maybe you mean something else, but Kofez, it doesn't really matter. All you need, if you want to do a pixel art game with whatever kind of 3D techniques you want, all you need to do is render everything to a very small frame buffer. And it totally depends on your game engine how you would go about doing that. But basically what's happening is you're rendering a 3D world into a very, very small pixel screen. We're talking like maybe 400 by 200 pixels, really small. And then when you go to finally render your game, you render that for tiny frame buffer into your big screen, and everything will be pixel perfect. That's exactly how Songbringer does its shadows right now. So you know, all the shadows are rendered, everything, not even just the shadows, everything in Songbringer is rendered to a frame buffer that's actually this size. It's 420 pixels wide or whatever. And then that gets rendered up. So you can see how small it is if I load it here in Photoshop. See what I mean? This is the frame buffer that it renders the game to, and then it scales up. So if you're using a 3D technique, it won't matter because you're rendering everything to that small buffer. It does the pixels for you perfectly. Did you get that? Does that make sense? Manic, what's up, man? Yo. Cool, man. Good. I'm glad it did. Yeah, you can do anything, make anything look like pixel art with frame buffers. It actually will be pixel art at that point. Okay, we're moving diagonally southwest right there. South, yeah, southwest. What up, Ziri? Progress so far? Man, I've released the alpha version this month. great progress with that. Now I'm working on the new beta version. This is the first day working on the new version. I'm starting with some really fundamental things like diagonal movement. And lots of people have requested diagonal movement. And so I'm trying it out. I had already put this in the game and took it out because it didn't feel right. But now it feels okay. What up, Cohen? Yeah, I hope I just answered that. No, yeah, Kofez, you do not need an orthographic camera to do pixel perfect art. Thanks, Marza. I saw you just probably did that. Zyanger, yes, you could play the alpha version, but it costs. So, yeah, you got it. You saw it. Yep. That's because the Kickstarter backers all, this started as a Kickstarter project, you know, and the Kickstarter backers, that was one of the rewards for the $64 backing level was you got access to the alpha. So in honor of all those people that have already paid to play the game, it's still that way. You have to pay $64 if you want to play the alpha version. You can also play the beta version, which is coming up in 3 months, or the final version comes out next year. Nice. Cool. Oh, yeah, right on. Right on. Cool. You found out what you're going to work on. Awesome. Well, keep me posted, man. I'd love to see what you're working on. Feel free to share screenshots on here. Share your progress. There's a lot of other game developers and people that have their own projects on here that I'm sure would love to root for you, too. Did I create my own pathfinding system? No. There's no pathfinding in this game. Yet. There probably will be eventually to get Jib walking around and avoiding obstacles and stuff. Oh, maybe you do. No, I don't think you do. I'm pretty sure I've seen this. I've seen other people do this with Unity. And it's definitely not an orthographic camera. And they render everything to a small frame buffer. So yeah, you don't need ortho. You don't need ortho to do a pixel perfect. Oh, all right. Oh, thanks, Flood. Nice, right on. Way to handle that. You're swift. Swift on the sword. Swift with the banhammer. Oh, does it? Oh, well, I don't know. I don't know. I've never really done it, so I'm just talking out my ass anyways. Yes, they are. Yep. There's quasi-pathfinding. If an enemy gets to an edge where they're trying to get across it, they smoothly move along it until they get past it. If they get stuck long enough, they just try a new direction. It's very simple. I guess it is kind of pathfinding, but it's not really a star or anything. Nice, right on. Oh, right. So I'm going to get the rest of these screenshots in here and we'll see if these are all lining up. Wait, did it? Yeah, there's one. Yeah, basically. Exactly. That's kind of how it works right now. They're small enough screens that it doesn't, you know, it's not too much of a big deal. But I probably will add, I will have to add a star pathfinding for when Jib starts colliding with obstacles. I just got Jib right now so he flies through everything. Keep it easy. All right, we got one direction left to check. Yeah, that looks okay. Right, so we've got the hitbox is about 32 by 48 or so. And this northwest one, northeast one. This is. What is this? Oh, this is north. Okay, this is northwest. Also, same size. Cool. This is regular north, which is going to have a totally different hitbox. Yeah, it's about 30 by 30. It's looking okay. So the diagonals are using the right boxes. So this one's west. This one's northwest. This one has about 16 pixels to the bottom there. This one has about 16 pixels. This hasn't changed at all going northwest. But southwest and southeast are working pretty well. Ooh, interesting. It did a different size for the block there. This is the south size block. Sorry, I really can't help you much here. I'm not really familiar with how that works. So the northeast and the northwest ones had a different size. Yes, give me Manic. No, I haven't tried VS Code. The new one, right? I've tried Visual Studio, of course, but VS Code, I haven't. Have you? Has it gotten? I heard. Okay, so some people were using it when on the live stream when it first came out. People were all using it, and people weren't that happy with it. That's the impression that I got. I don't know. What have you used it? You like it? What is it for you, man? Am curious. There's definitely a movement problem right now. So if I start moving left, if I start moving directly east, and then I move to going diagonal, it doesn't work until I change to north. So it's like ignoring those east, west, or oh, I know why. Okay, yeah, I'll get to work on that in a second. So that'll be the next thing to dial in after this. In fact, actually, maybe I should do this first because it's making it really hard to do these diagonal. Yeah, let's dial that in first. So the goal now is to make it so when he moves left and right, he should be able to move left and then move diagonal. Oh, it worked that time. So weird. It doesn't work sometimes. Oh, right on. Yeah, right. Oh, yeah, input component, I think. It was where, yeah, input component is where it takes its input. Yo, Caviar, what's up, man? How you been? Here it is, get compass direction. Yeah, all right, so if the flags are allow four, this is the new code, which is pretty good. It does a much better check for how it checks if a button is down. Because if a button is down and then you start pressing another button, that can change, that should change the direction, but then still allow the other direction if you let off of a key. For example, if you're pressing left and then you start pressing up as well, it should do a diagonal movement, and then if you let go of left, it should allow you to do up. Or if you let go of up, it should allow you to do left again. So that's kind of how this code works, as opposed to this code, which is just way more basic. This doesn't actually work. Actually, this should all just be commented out. Fact. What's it? So your name's not Caviar? Whoa, what am I saying? What am I supposed to say? Hey, what up, Barcore? It's not much better. All right. Nice. Huh. Really? Okay, yeah, that's why people weren't really giving it rave reviews when people were discussing it on the stream the other day. So really what I gotta do is migrate to using this code for eight compass directions as well as oh, this might have been what was causing the blobs to not work. So Arcor, anybody else has just joined the stream? I'm working on diagonal movement today. 3 seg vaults in a row, dude. That's the magic number. You got it's a jackpot. You should win like $20 right now. So bear with me all today, you guys. My brain is slow. So slow. Right? Okay, so is button directional? So this describes the latest directional button. Yeah, I do. I tried to rest all weekend, right? But it wasn't very restful weekend. So I gotta figure out how to get some more rest because I do need to recharge my freaking batteries. My development batteries are low right now. Nice, right on, man. Yeah, well, sorry I'm not really much of a help here with this. But I'm sure whatever it is, you'll figure it out. And when you do, please let us know. You know, if you have time, if you feel like it, come by, say, hey, dude, I figured it out. We'll all root for you and be like, yes. Way to go, Kofez. Right, that one? The crash at the end? That was so weird. And then it happened to me the next day. Not on the stream. It crashed again. It's El Capitan, man. El Capitan. It's got this weird crash bug in Safari. Yeah, don't feel sorry for me using a Mac, right? That is my problem, right? What do I need, dude? Cold fusion? Cold fusion? Do I just need to be hardwired into the system? Is that it? Okay, so my challenge right here is this. I'll do it again. I'll show you what the challenge is. And I know the code to fix it is right here. I just have to fix it. But anyways, if the player is moving left, right, that works perfect right now. But so diagonal movement is in here. It's working, right? See, the player is moving diagonally. It feels all right. But the problem is this. If I move left and then go diagonal, it doesn't work. So I'm left, right, same thing. If I go, I just moved it to go diagonal, and it should have moved diagonal, but it doesn't. That's because it already has a compass direction that's moving in, and it's just the way the code works. So I've got to improve the code so that it can allow diagonal movement if you've already been moving in a direction. So that's it. And this is kind of how it works for this bit of code, but it's specific to just 4 directions instead of 8. So I got to find out a better way to do it for these, for that. Oh, really? I never knew Atom is kind of slow. I've got it. I just haven't been really using it. I've been stuck with, you know, TextMate. TextMate works for me. Marza, Texas, Marza. Okay. That makes sense. So it's grabbing the very latest directional index. If there's, we need 2 directional indexes though. Like latest and second latest, I guess. That right? Is that right? Is that the right way to do it? Mjolnir is pink today. I do. I do. I wanted. I kind of want to do this, but I don't. You ever have those days where your brain just doesn't work? I'm supposed to be professional, but I don't feel like one today. First things first, we shouldn't be using this old 8-direction code. We should be using this newer thing, which looks at the last time a direction was pressed. I wonder if this is button directional thing works. Ah, see, that's the problem. It's only allowing one button, but really up or up and left is a combination of up and left, of course. Northwest is north and west. Oh, yeah. Ah, nice one, nice one. Punny. So if we're going to get into this loop with north and west, for example, it's going to loop over all the buttons and it's going to find north down and west down as well at the end. And they're probably going to have differing times or close to the same time. Oh, maybe we should just do. You're never gonna transition the control from if you're like this and you're never gonna transition from northwest immediately to southwest. You're always gonna transition through west or transition through back through center down to southeast or northeast. So I think it's a little bit easier than I'm making it. In fact, we can just check if, check diagonals first. So that would just be if we've got up and left. Yeah, this will work, I think. Awesome. Yo, what's up, Xbox Taco? It does, it's super green. These colors. Whoa, 24-hour game dev stream? Dude, give that guy a high five, man. Send him $5 or something. Seriously. That's tough. 24 hours? Who's doing that? That's amazing. Is this actually gonna fly? Oh, 2D game dev. Twenty-four-hour marathon night. Good job, man. I gotta check out his stream. Oh wow. Yeah, that sounds hard. Really hard. There. Okay, now we're checking the diagonals first. I think this is what it needs. So basically, if it's got two compass directions. I mean, I'm not sure how the hell somebody's controller would return more than one direction at once. I guess if you're playing on an Xbox controller and you had, you know, you're using your D-pad and your one of these, I guess you could get more than one direction. So I guess it is important to check for all four of these, but I think this is going to work. Let's try it out. Basically, it'll use this if there's diagonals and this cooler method if it's got a single direction. Oh, it works really well now. Oh yeah, I can move the player like in a sine wave. Oh, this is great. Actually, okay, now this is really... No wonder I was probably cranky about the freaking diagonal movement before, because it was horrible. This is really smooth and nice. Excellent. Oh my god. Very good fix. Did you guys see that? Did you see that? I coded something? Pure Beaver, is this a bot? Are you a bot, Pure Beaver? What up, Lighter Thief? Yo, man. Okay, this is awesome. Let's delete this old school stuff. This is horrible. See ya. And then this is really awesome to use both these methods. It is a bot. Oh, here's another one. Two bots in a row. Ban. Ban. Is there a way of merging multiple arrays with the same size into one array without making the final array bigger size? What? What do you mean? Because if you were to merge two arrays, of course the array is going to grow. You're talking about adding two arrays? Like adding all of the individual? I would just do that with the regular loop, man. I hope I understood your question right, though. You wish you were a bot? Marzat? He's like a time-traveling robot, I think. Marzat, are you really a robot, or are you just programmed to be seeming like a human? Marzat's got some pretty special powers. He could definitely time travel. Uh, Yeah, you can in if you're talking about a vector in C++, you can. If you're talking about a C array, no, you technically can't, but you can relocate. No, I don't. Who's that? Is that an author? Sounds like the name of an author. Don't need that. A coin should jump above your head. That would be awesome. It would be way more fun. Crash Lemon. Cool. You're offering a cool suggestion here. Let me try and understand a little bit better. Sorry, my brain's slow. Did you ever think of using input plus one, minus one, and just normalize the vector for direction? I think I see what you're saying. Oh no. So, yeah, that's a great idea. It's a great idea, right? And actually, that does work that way in a different system. But for this system, this is the input component system. This is at the level before it's processed vectors, okay? This code has no idea about vectors. It only has ideas about buttons that are down or up. Or released. So good point, Crash Lemon. But yeah, it does already work that way in a different part of the code. This is just dealing with buttons. Thanks for suggesting that, man. Thank you for shouting out. That's a very you got some good code eyes there. Oh, you're talking about C sharp. Oh, you lost the stream? We were just saying some funny stuff, man. Oh. Okay, now that that's right, let's make sure that the actual diagonal the diagonal hitboxes for the melee are still they're the style is in. There's something wrong with the I think the north, west, and southwest ones. Oh my God, this is so much better with this smooth movement. Wow. Okay, so we've got east, west. You can see the hitbox is just like barely is mostly above. Wait a minute. Something weird is happening. So if I go immediately, oh, something's wrong still. So what I'm doing here is I'm just starting right where I am, and then I'm pressing directly diagonal, and it's not working. Wait, there it did. Hold on. Yeah, it doesn't work. It's like he has to get a running start or something. Why doesn't that work? Huh. Okay. Well, next thing to fix. That's really important, right? You want to be able to just inch your way, have fine-tuned controls for everything. Did the stream die or something? That looks okay. Okay, what? I wonder if it's these and not up, not right things. Or maybe it's just that it hasn't even pressed those buttons yet. Oh, yeah, see, I knew something was up with that. Whoa. Sorry about that, you guys. The chat just suddenly puked out like a page or two on my screen here for you guys, so Sorry, I lost some of the chat history there. I think it was happening on mine too. I don't know what happened. I don't know what happened, but I'm back, I guess, and you guys are back too. Who did? Who traveled through time and just did that? Seriously, there was a ripple in the force and time itself. So, okay, let me show you what I was doing right there, because you guys probably didn't see. I found out there's another kind of little bug with this new input diagonal thing. So if I start here and I just try and do a simple diagonal movement directly from starting, it does not work. It only goes left or right or up or down. I can't move diagonally right off the starting blocks. So I got to figure out what's up with that, because that's really going to help with attacking and stuff. Read your prediction. Let's see if I can do that without the chat going weird on me. Probably his internet went off. He'll keep talking for 5 minutes. Yep. Happens every time. Yep. You guys know me. But what else am I supposed to do, you know? I know, it's Twitch's fault. Oh, cool, Crash Lemon. Yeah, that's awesome. I like it, man. I like the color of his sword. You could maybe add a little shading to the sword, unless you want that sword to kind of look, have a glow look or something. I don't know. I think it's cool. Looks like a sweet character you started. Hey, what up, Ethan? Welcome, man. Okay, so what I'm trying to think of, what would be causing it to not allow this diagonal movement right off the starting blocks? It's just only one direction at first. It might have to do with this. These not up, not down stuff. I don't know. This doesn't feel right, but I'm going to try it so I don't assume anything else later. Still doesn't work. But what if I try the keyboard? Oh, the keyboard works fine. Oh, so it must be somehow the way input is handled in the controllers, in the actual vector input, or what is it? It's not vector input. It's something else. Input, where art thou? Here we go. Controllers. Don't play it. All right. Cool, man. What's it called? All right. This is where does it do? Axis move. This is probably what it's going to be. Cool, man. Good for you. Are we? Yeah. Dang. I hope my game isn't like just amongst one of them compared to Star Wars, because it's sci-fi. But yeah. Really? You've never seen Star Wars? Whoa. Yeah, it always sets both buttons for the axis. Why are these both equal to? Oh, okay, that makes sense. Wow. You never seen the original three? What? They're so much better than the new ones. Oh, by choice. Interesting. Wow. Wow. I really want to try my other gamepad first, see if this other one has any issues. Let's do these bindings. This look kind of this is kind of like a divide and conquer strategy, right? Because the input is working fine for a keyboard. We got perfect diagonal movement. So I'm wondering if the other controller type is fine as well. Let's add some bindings for this. I'm using a Nintendo style controller. This one has a different kind of D-pad. The axes work differently than the Xbox controller. So I want to make sure that it's not just the Xbox controller. Yeah, it doesn't work on this one either. Not always. Like, for example, I'm pressing directly up and left, and he just moves left. See, that time he did move diagonally, but it looked like he might have moved up first. So it's like it's only doing one at a time. So, well, gotta improve this system, how this works. Yeah. You watch Spaceballs, but not Star Wars. Okay, with the axes, it works a little differently than the other input. Ah, here it is, where it uses the greatest axis value. Oh, this totally makes sense now. Okay, so it's only doing one axis at a time. Is that right? Really? Or Alien? Oh man. Both incredible movies. You gotta see Alien as well. Don't know. I like Prometheus even better though. Prometheus is rad. Can't wait for the next movie in that series. Okay, this is the problem right here. Yeah, it's only doing one axis at a time. It's only enabling one at a time. So that's why it's not allowing the both of them to be down. I think I did this because of the way it was setting bindings. It was really messing things up. For example, if I, it was actually the Xbox controller. Let's get that one back in here. The Xbox controller, you can do the analog style stick. So, it was really hard to bind keys, right? So if you wanted to bind your analog stick, it's like, okay, you want to bind left? Great. You want to bind up? Great. But if the player accidentally had a little bit of left and up, that's why I wanted to use only one axis at a time, right? So it's important to be able to keep this code to work this way, but I think I want to be able to make it have work either way, depending on what kind of state the game is in, whether it's binding keys or not. Oh, good. Nice, right on. Is it copyrighted? Is it going to give me some weird issue though on the stream? What up, Grim Gary? What? You didn't like Prometheus? Oh, I loved it. Yeah, it's very alien, right? Hey, what's up, Voice of Grog? Yay! Nice, yeah, right? Good. So you just use a for loop, combine those arrays how you mean to. Perfect, man. Okay, this is important, very important to fix this, but I don't want to break the existing system. So, man, I wish my brain was working like normal. Yeah. Yep, I'm here too. I'm in the closet too. I'm officially halfway in the closet. Half of the closet contains me. All right, I'll check this out. On the release day, you're the monsters. Cool. I've always wanted real monsters in my closet. I believe this use greatest axis is called from the tick. Yeah, so it uses all the latest ones for any pair and latest axis values. Use greatest axis value for. Oh, that's only for this axis. Wait, this should be working. Okay, I did design this right, I think. Oh my God, I do not even want to look at that. Yeah, JList, dude, I got it so deep into so many bugs. There's like when I started making the alpha version, right? I had only what, like 100 bugs left or whatever. And then by the time the alpha version was done, it's like up to two. And I had fixed bugs along the way. There's like 200 bugs now or something crazy. I don't even want to look at that list right now. I just want to be creative with the game and not at all be looking at all the skeletons in my closet. I'm scared of the skeletons. What happened, man? What happened? Oh, is it late? Is it late? Well, good night, man. Good night. I know it's that towel throwing time. ID pair first. Maybe it's not respecting. Oh, yeah. It gives you device hash. Oh, wait. This is a device hash of, okay, latest access values is device hash access. So then it uses the latest access values for a device hash. Okay, so yeah, we need to make a way that it can use two at a time. And for that to be able to be a switch, turn on, turn off. Yes, right on, dude. Oh, cool. I know you've been doing some dope procedurally generated worlds, so you got any screenshots you want to share? Yeah, good night, man. Good night, dude. Whoa, did you change your color? What happened? Oh, yeah. Oh, you shared some stuff. Cool. You want to send a link to something else that you created? Or have you sent any screenshots up of this? If not, don't worry, man. But I'm proud for you, man. Proud of you. Definitely time to celebrate.
No shits are given. Not one single solitary shit is being given right here.
Wow. Is it really that kind of world now? Holy crap. Did we just all witness that, right? Yeah, that's crazy. Man. Makes me nervous because we got all these security cams outside of our house now because somebody tried to break into our neighbor's storage thing. Cameras, drones. We got so much of this stuff. Okay, what I gotta do is allow it to use two axes at once. Okay. So we would loop through, find an axis. Okay, so we'll make this a different function. Int axis. Oh, we need to return an axis and a val. Void get greatest axis. We need a device hash. We need an axis that it's not. And we need to return the axis and the value. I know, right? Oh, man. Okay, so this loops through the latest axis, given the device hash. And if the So the axis is the pair.first. So the pair.first is not equal to not axis, and it's greater than your existing value. Let's do this. Let's make sure these are reset when we start all this too. And then this bit here could be part of that method there. So we got axis value. Both of these can be safely be uninitialized because this function will do it. So we'll go this get greatest axis, not axis. Oh, not axis. Start with -1, so it allows all axes. Axis val, that should be the same as the existing code, and then we can, now we're in a flexible point where we can use this again to get the second greatest axis. Hey Solar Flare, what's up, man? Welcome. Yes, it does. I'm working on that right now. Let me show you where I'm at with that. The C++ one, I recommend this one, Arcore, c++.com. Okay, so yeah, Solar Flare, anybody else that's just joined the stream, I'm working on diagonal movement right now. So many people requested it in this latest alpha version. It's kind of weird that no one requested it before, but I guess it's because, you know, people, not many people were playing the game before. So I've got diagonal movement in here, and you can see I can get a nice little sine wave going on here. The player can walk in all these diagonal directions. You can attack in diagonal directions and stuff. I'm just working on the actual input now. So, for example, there's just one little issue. Everything is cool, except if I want to start moving diagonally. If I'm using the keyboard, no problem. I can move instantly diagonally. That's all good. But there's an issue if I try and, if I got my Xbox controller here and I try and move, start with just a diagonal movement, it never moves diagonally first. And that's because I've got some code that processes the controllers and limits how many axes are being processed at once. So I'm working on the actual controller code now, so you can actually get some really, really nice, smooth movement going out diagonal. Regarding diagonal movement, I originally designed the game to be able to do diagonal or regular movement, and then I limited it so it wouldn't have any diagonal movement because it just didn't feel right at first. This was intended to be an 8-bit Zelda, original Zelda style game. And so, but now that I'm trying it out again, it feels all right. I don't know what it was before, but now it's actually feeling pretty good. And it's actually kind of more fun, I think, than just having four directions. So I think this is going to be something that's going to be a permanent part of the game, diagonal movement. And I just got to work on this, this function here to get these going. Yeah, use that one. I recommend. Yeah, it's pretty good. Yeah, it kind of is. The Microsoft pages are always kind of more Windows-y. Yeah. Cool, man. Glad you got that dialed in. Okay, so I think this is what it is right here. We finally got this get greatest axis. It still worked. That's good. Okay, so I want to get the greatest axis. Really, this should be... I'm going to write this in all caps. So I remember to change this. So yeah, if we're not binding keys, then we can choose the second greatest axis. Hey, what up, Akuma? Sorry, remind me. So yeah, I'll make another little helper function. This will be called use axis. That's all we need, really. We need the device hash. And the axis and the vowel. Hey, what up, Lime? Oh. Yeah. Oh, yeah, yeah. Totally, man. That's right. Yeah, don't worry about it. Just do it anyways. And I tell you what, I'm actually about to release my Kickstarter post. So probably this Wednesday. This Wednesday I'm going to do like my, I'm going to release my Kickstarter post. So maybe that helps you. I don't know. It probably doesn't. Your situation is kind of unique in that you're, I think that if I understand correctly, you're kind of worried about the fact that you already have the funds you need, but you still want to do a Kickstarter. I really don't think it matters. I think the point is people want to be involved with the project anyway. So you're giving them rewards anyways. You're giving them the reward of getting the game or what you're going to have. I'm sure you're going to have other digital rewards too. So it doesn't matter. Those people that are investing money into your project, and they're getting a reward out of it. So don't worry that you already have the funds you need. Yes, yeah. Yes, exactly. Yeah, man. Yeah. And this is something that almost everyone goes through, right? You go through these issues, right? Do you feel like you're being greedy? Are you really being greedy? No, you're not. You're not. It's cool that you're thinking that though. It means you're a cool person. So I hope the stream didn't just die or whatever. We've been having some stream dying issues today. Yeah, exactly. You're also kind of pre-ordering, pro-ordering, and advertising. And yeah, it's advertising in the sense that you're developing awareness for your project and you're building kind of an initial core following. The people that are going to follow you on Kickstarter are going to be people that are completely stoked about your project. If they're willing enough to pay for it before it comes out, good, good. If they're willing to pay for it before it comes out, you know they're like a hardcore kick-ass fan, you know. You're not going to reach everyone, too. You know, some people, even though you're going to do a great Kickstarter campaign or whatever, you're going to develop a small following or whatever to start with, down the road, you're going to have an even bigger following because it's just that's the way awareness works. You know, you get more and more visible and more discoverable the more you promote your game. Yeah, all right. This goes back to worthiness issues and deservability issues too. You know, that has a lot to do with money and asking for money. You know what, Akuma, I've got the awesomest post for you, and Lime too. You've got to watch this. Amanda Palmer's, she did a TED talk. You got to watch this. This is all about what you're dealing with right now. You gotta check this out. This might change your entire world, man. Check this out. Both you guys, anybody else too, that's watching the stream. You're like, what the heck are we talking about? We're talking about asking. We're just really, that's all we're talking about is asking. Yeah, can't deliver. That's a big fear. Yeah. All right, man. Akuma, you got to check this link out, though, man. Save this or something. Yes. Yeah, exactly. It is totally the PR and the pre-orders. Basically, just the, yeah. Uh-huh. Yeah, she's cool. Yeah, so many little fears, right? If anybody's looking for ways to deal with their fears, I wrote an article on that too. I'm just going to post this anyways. This is probably the most important thing I could possibly share. How come I can never find this article? Yeah, there are two great links regarding these issues, these kind of fear issues. Check out both of these if anybody's in that place where you're wondering about that and you need to work on those kind of things. All right, so the code should still work as it did. Awesome, right on. Yeah, it will probably not be a real book for many years, but I do eventually intend for this to be a real book. It'll actually be a book of just about being creative in general for people that are, you know, looking to get into the creative career, you know, career path, I guess, or people that are already in the creative careers. And they're just they're trying to break through the next level of their own skills or something. You know, it's just gonna be a free book too. It's not gonna cost money. Okay, good. Yeah, the input, everything is still working as it did, but I still can't move diagonally off the block. But now we've got everything ready, so we can do two directions at once with this code. So let's do it. How to get through Steam Greenlight? I don't have any tips on console development because I really haven't done it. But Steam Greenlight, it's really easy, man. Well, I guess it was easy because I did it in concert with a Kickstarter. So my general tips for doing a Steam Greenlight would be prepare well. So you want to have kick-ass video, great GIFs, animated GIFs, and you want to have, you know, great screenshots. Basically just have a great, all your marketing materials prepared, your description, everything, all that ready to go. Pay for your green light too. You want to have your $100 paid up so you can be on Steam Greenlight. You want to have an initial following too. So you can't, I would never recommend anyone just doing a Steam Greenlight or a Kickstarter without having prepared adequately in developing a following. Like, you've got to have a following. Whether that's people following you on Twitter or Twitch or Tumblr or Facebook or whatever, you have to have enough of a following that it's, if you want to get through Steam Greenlight quickly, I guess you could just throw your game up on Steam Greenlight and kind of hope for the best. But my recommendation in general is to build a following first. I do have a threshold I'd recommend. I'd recommend you have about 1,000 followers combined on whatever social networks you have for your game. So like, if you're on Twitter and Facebook and Tumblr, combine all those. And if you're at about 1,000, I think that's a good place to start. But you can be a little less if you're not doing a Kickstarter. If you're just doing a Steam Greenlight, you know, maybe less than that. I don't know. Because Steam Greenlight's great because you can actually build a following through that too. And same thing with Kickstarter, but Kickstarter is really critical that you have a following already because you're not guaranteed to be discovered. You know, Kickstarter is something where you pretty much have to drive all the traffic there yourself. You have to at least have that confidence that you can, because pretty much there's no guarantees that Kickstarter is going to make your project discoverable, because there's a lot of projects now these days. Oh man, I hope this is kind of making sense, but really, I wouldn't make Steam out to be too much of a big deal. Steam Greenlight was pretty easy compared to doing a Kickstarter. But I did them both at the same time, so maybe it just seemed easier. But my impression is it's really not that hard. And actually, the longer you're on Steam Greenlight, the better. Like, let's say you throw up your project on Steam Greenlight and it's going really slowly, you're not quite getting the fans you need to click yes or whatever, it doesn't matter. The longer you're on there, the more people are becoming aware of your project. So, yeah. I don't know. I just say make sure you've got great screenshots and a great video first. Once you've got those two things, it's going to make it easy. I think so. I mean, it depends on your project and what you prefer and stuff. What's your green light, man? Post a link, please. Hello, Nasser. All right, let's make this a little simpler. So when we're getting the greatest axis, it's going to invalidate the axis if the value is too low. So if the value is less than the threshold, then we're gonna invalidate. Or I guess it'd be better to just check this in the loop. So if the abs value is greater than the threshold, yeah. Uh-huh. Okay, yeah, I know what you mean. You might, I see what it means to do something too early here on stream. Sweet, dude. I'm just turning off the music because I don't know if that's copyrighted or something. Oh, yeah, you've showed me this. Yeah. Cool, dude. Oh, I definitely would not say you're too early on this. This looks pretty polished, man. How's it going for you? Are you getting enough people? How long has it been on here? Maybe you can have a better screenshot. This really helps, Slime Studios. This really, really helps. If you have an animated GIF as your screenshot, you'll get so much more attention on Greenlight. Do that. Go make an animated GIF that's really kind of exciting, you know, kind of like shows your game a little bit, and use that as your thumbnail. And then also, you want to go and make sure you've got images. At least one image in your description. Just kind of fun up your description a little bit. Make it a little more fun with some images. And that'll really help. Look at this. Oh, you're already getting some great comments. Look at this. Yeah. 4 pages of comments. Good job, man. You need to have a private paid class to learn Unity? Yeah, it's fine. You can post a link, of course. How do you do that? I think you have to upload to their Steam system and then reference the image somehow. You might just want to use Imgur. I'm pretty sure you can do that. Just post it to Imgur and then link to your Imgur image in here. I think images were like image or something like that. I don't know. Yeah, Fitz, yeah. And you can't really do that with your actual screenshots. Oh, also, I would recommend maybe only one video. That's my recommendation. I don't know. This totally might be better for your situation to have 4 videos. But I don't know. I think that one video is enough. And then one video and some screenshots. Yeah, of course, man. Hope there's somebody in here maybe that's willing to teach you or something. Or also, if there's anybody watching this video on YouTube, you know, here's that link. Nasser's looking for somebody to teach him some Unity tutoring and all that. All right, good work, Lime Studios. Yeah, I agree, right? One video. It looks like you're well on the way, man. If you've already got 34 comments, yeah. Just a couple little tweaks here will really help you move through this faster. If you want to go faster. Oh, no. Oh, my computer just did the freaking crash thing. Oh, is the stream? I don't even know if the stream's up anymore. Well, I'm gonna have to kill Safari if it even comes back up. I don't know if you guys are even watching this. Damn it. What's up? El Capitan, you suck. Seriously. I should have never upgraded to El Capitan. Oh, what? It was. Were you back? No, not back. Yeah, it might be ripped, dude. I don't know if you guys can even hear me. I can see you guys. Whoa, is it back? Wait. Hold on. I'm gonna have to kill Safari if this even works. I'm gonna have to get the chat window back open. Okay, let's see if the broadcaster is still broadcasting. It looks like it is. Sorry, guys. El Capitan Safari sucks balls. It has this crazy hang bug where it just. Ugh. Hate it. Well, are we back? Not yet. Doing it again though. I've got this crazy laggy cursor now. Ugh. You called it? You're like it was probably Safari hanging. Besides, I'm already over 2 hours, so I should probably stop the stream soon and get some dinner. But I want to check one thing before I leave. I want to check if this worked with the getting greatest access thing. Do this, oh, now it doesn't work at all. Really? I ruined it. You blew it. I'm telling you guys, it's so weird. It's like Safari hangs, and then everything else goes crazy too. Like my system just gets hosed. Is the sound off? It shouldn't be. Hello. It looks like it's on. Oh, it's hanging. Oh. The recording is going crazy. Oh, it's going in and out. I gotta close it now. Something's going crazy. Yeah, no drop frames. Oh. Well, yeah. I gotta stop the stream. What is going on?